The Speaker, Justin Okunobo, who was represented by his deputy, Elizabeth Ativier, thanked participants for the useful contribution during the public hearing. She said the two-day public hearing has helped to broaden the scope of the grazing bill and assured the public that the legislative and executive arm will put heads together to fine-tune the bill in the interest of Edo people.
For the past 2 days, has been very revealing, a lot of exposition, and have enlightened our horizon.
Also commenting, the chairman of the Joint Committee of the Grazing Bill, Henry Okwarabo, commended the success of the public hearing owing to the different views profiled by the participants.
Edo people decide, and by this presentation, we have by and by decided what we have.
Different groups ranging from academicians, civil society, the Nigeria Union of Journalists, among others, contributed to the bill. There was divided opinions, as some were optimistic that fine-tuning the bill and amending some portions would bring about the desired results, while others rejected in totality, stressing that existing laws relating to criminal activities perpetrated by the herdsmen be revisited.
The peaceful coexistence of our people in the Edo State is sacrosanct for us. I am deciding that this law ought not to be at all, because it's already an existing law.
We vehemently, overtly, and covertly condemn and therefore reject in totality the proposed grazing bill.
The title of the bill should have read Anti-Grazing Bill. If it seeks to prohibit the grazing of cattle in open places and farmer, which has led to the destruction of farm produce
industry, for coming up with a bill of this nature at this critical moment when the lives of Edo people have been lamentably threatened by the unruly conduct of some Fulani herdsmen.
Let the law enforcement agents arrest them for illegal possession of firearms and let them prosecute the owners of those cows.
Public hearing almost degenerated into a rowdy session following the utterances of a participant which did not go down well with others. The timely intervention of the Deputy Speaker, Elizabeth Ativier, and other members, however, brought the situation under control. A minute's silence was observed for those that have lost their lives to the alleged atrocities of herdsmen. Friday's session officially brought the public hearing to a close. Efosa Wangwe reporting.